the whole movie is intensely creepy because, as ridiculous and outlandish as the scenario is, there's something about it that's kind of believable in some strange way that I don't really understand. I guess it's just the domestic nature of it all. We recognize so many of the world about it. And the scariest part for me, I think the scariest part for me is the end. I love the end of the movie. When I read it in the script, I loved it. I thought it was really smart and really terrifying. Sinister is basically about a guy who is at the end of his rope as far as his career and is longing for one more shot at the limelight, and thinks that if he moves into this house where this horrible homicide has happened, this whole family has been killed, he will be able to write a great novel about them. And obviously, for obvious reasons, he doesn't tell his wife about it. And that's basically the setup of it. He moves his family into this house where this horrible thing happened, and in order to research this murder. And that's the first 3 minutes of the movie. Then the rest happens. The character of Ellison is, in any genre of film, a really complex character. And in particularly this genre, inside the horror genre, a lot of times in genre films, you're asked to play cardboard cutouts of people, even in a comedy or anything that... And this guy was really interesting to me. He was not a good person or a bad person. He was a really complex person. And those are the most fun to play. And also the script works in regards to like telling a good story. And it has wit to it, which I like. And all good genre movies, I think, should operate. First of all, you know, if it's a horror movie, it's gotta be scary. It's gotta be really scary. And at their best, they also have some kind of underlining metaphor to them. And this one is a very kind of clear and obvious one about a guy who puts his own ambition ahead of his family. And, you know, watch what happens when you do that. Well, one of the things that I love about this movie is that the most horrific parts of it don't really happen. They happen in these found footage to these old home movies that he's found. And so I got to, you know, my character has to watch the movie. And so the director just showed me the movies and filmed me watching, which was so kind of wonderful to get to do. And they're both incredibly creepy and kind of elegiac at the same time. You know, that's what I liked about them.
New details today in the grisly murders of a local family found earlier this week.
I didn't want to move here.
We couldn't afford to live in the old house anymore. Plus, the new story I'm writing is here.
Is the story a good one this time?
I'm going to write the best book that anybody's ever read. I got a really good feeling about this.
You gotta be kidding me. Family hanging out. Barbecue 79. That's the family who lived here.
You think these are serial murders?
I don't know. The first one I found dates back to the 60s. The only link between all these cases is the symbol.
The symbol is associated with a pagan deity named Bagul. He consumes the souls of human children.
Bagul actually lived in the images themselves, and that they were gateways into his realm. Children exposed to the images were especially vulnerable to Bagul's abduction.
Sweetheart, what are you doing?
Painting. I wanted to paint her picture.
Who are you talking about?
Stephanie. She used to live here.
Shut her.
What's the matter? What's happened?
Get the kids. Pack the car. We have to leave here now.